All right, DIYers, for your home improvement pleasure today, I'm going to be running and installing my Ring Floodlight motion sensor camera on the front of my garage. And to do this, I'm going to need to run some Romex power cable from an outlet and need to use some of these fastener staples to the ceiling to hold the cable there. I've got my wire nuts. This is the mount for the camera itself. And what I'm going to need to do is show you guys my garage. My power source is that outlet there. And you can see here's my garage door opener. There's the front of my garage. What I'm going to have to do is run power out of that outlet because it's a constant power. Similar to what I did here, it's kind of hard to see, but that is the actual garage door opener power. I'm going to run it down the front of the garage and then out through the wall. Can't see it right now because the garage door is up. And then it'll come out and actually be mounted on the front of the garage right there. I actually did this on a previous house. The only tough part is actually drilling through the face of the wall and then running the cable through. But it's a pretty simple job. Should be able to do it quickly. So the first thing I'm going to do is start to run my cable and then drill my hole and then be able to easily screw this in because this needs constant power. This is a AC power version. They do make some versions of this that are DC. They're a little bit more, battery power. They're a little bit more expensive. Planning on getting one of those for the front of the house, but I got this one already, and this is like a $200 unit at least, so I don't want to just get rid of it. So the easiest thing to do is to just run power for it out to the front of the garage. So I'm going to get started on that, and we'll see how it looks. So one of the first things you need to do is measure how far up from where the garage door or the top of the garage door is on the exterior. So I stuck my tape measure down in there, pulled it up, and want to figure out where I'm going to be drilling this hole through the outside. So roughly it's about 18 inches here to the top of where my rail is for my garage door opener. This gives me enough clearance to run it from the ceiling down and out. So if I put the hole like right here at 18 inches, it might be a good spot. So now I want to go outside and see where 18 inches is on the exterior. So measuring 18 inches up is actually a really good spot. It's hard to see with my shadow, but 18 inches is actually right in the middle of this piece of siding, which is exactly where I want it to be. So I can run the cable out there, and that'll actually, even if like the circle of the mount is maybe hanging down below this, that's okay, because I can shift that kind of up. It gives me a little bit of wiggle room once the cable comes through, but that's a perfect spot, 18 inches up. So now the key is to lining it up on the inside, right down the middle of the garage. So I'm gonna go back inside and mark that spot and start from the inside and go out. All right, so I've marked my spot dead center over the rail at 18 inches up from the bottom of the, or from the top of the garage door rather. And so now I'm going to drill just straight through the wall all the way to the exterior. If this bit isn't long enough, I'm gonna have to pick up a bigger one. But obviously when you're drilling, it's easier to start small and then go bigger. Using a longer bit, I was able to get through. So you can see where 18 inches up pops through in reality with that hole marked on the other side. So it's a little below center, but that's gonna be totally fine for mounting our bracket. Next, I'm gonna run the wire through to give just enough slack on this side that will then allow us to run it all the way back to that outlet. Okay, so what I did was fish some of this Romex through the hole. And also to clarify too, I used a half inch bit to drill through the wood and the drywall and the vinyl on the other side. It was one of those like 1 foot bits. So I used a half incher in case you're curious of the size. And now I've taken my Romex and I've fished some of it through. And what I'm gonna do is open the garage back up, go on the other side, pull enough of the length through that I need to work on it on that side. And then once it's done on that side, then I'm gonna go through and staple it all along the wall, or excuse me, the ceiling, all the way to the power source. The reason I have the bundle taped up here against the wall is because I have nowhere to set it, and I don't want it to get caught on the garage contraptions as things start to move. So I'm taping this here because when the garage door comes up, I have no way of getting at this roll. So I just taped it to the wall for now to hold it in place with enough slack that I can pull through what I need on the other side. So let's go outside. Okay, so I've pulled about a foot or so of the Romex through my hole, and that's plenty to work with. Honestly, that's too much, and I'll be cutting that off once I put the mount up. So that's what I'm gonna do next, is put the mount, secure everything on this side, and then I can pull the cable tighter back through the hole and start stapling it toward the power source. So the next part is actually put the mount up for the camera. So the mount is actually super simple. Just slide it over the wire, hold it up, and it's got a bunch of different locations for mounting screws. I'm actually gonna use these that are like at 10 and 2 o'clock on each side. And then you just throw some flathead bolts, or not bolts, wood screws in there to screw it in, and that'll hold it in place. So I'm gonna mount that up, and then we'll put the camera on. All right, I've got the power cables on the camera itself. Wire nutted tight onto the Romex. So I've got the black to black, white to white, ground to ground, all set and ready to go. And then the camera is going to go right on these two bolts here with nice little fashion heads that screw on, and it'll be mounted to the wall. And then this side will be done. Also, one cool thing what Ring does is this is like a rubber seal around here. So this actually creates a weather proof seal around that. So if there's rain or anything, it won't be getting into any of these electronics. So let's put this thing up and see how it looks. Okay, the camera is up and looking good. What I did is I pulled that Romex cable as tight as I could, with still enough slack to be able to just kind of fashion that in place, but I pulled it back through so there's no need to cut anything on this side, and then I'll have enough cable to run it to the power source. But the camera's up. The next step with the camera itself is once everything is powered up and it's on, you sync it to your Ring app and then have a look at the camera just to make sure it's positioned correctly. So the lights can be positioned in different directions and this camera itself can be positioned. This one's up pretty high, so I've got this pointed pretty far down right now, but you know, we'll make any fine adjustments until we actually turn the power on and can see what it looks like. But the camera part is done. Now moving on to the power. All right, so the next step here is to start tacking up the Romex wire all along the ceiling back to the power. And I'm just gonna follow the same line that I did with these tiny little skinny garage door opener sensor cables that I already tacked up. I'm actually gonna just run this thick cable in line with them and then just add the new nail tacks along it. I just help re-secure it, just keep it in the same space. I'm using these half inch tacks like this, and they'll just tack up into the ceiling. I'm gonna try to find the studs as I go along and tack into those for extra support. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, tack them up, and show you guys what it looks like when it's done all the way down back to the power source. All right, so I've got my wire tacked up along the ceiling. Looking good. Running it all the way down. And I've left a good foot and a half of slack for me to play with when I pull this outlet out. So the next part is to do that, is to connect the cable to the power. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm going to turn the power off, and then I'm going to obviously unplug the garage door opener and my extension cord here, pull the outlet plate out and expose the outlet itself so that I can wire up the Romex. Okay, so I have all the wiring attached. And what's nice about this, when I pulled out this outlet, is that the builders ran the power to the outlet actually in some of these little back slots on the backside of this, so that left the screws wide open for me to connect my power to the camera too on both sides. And so I just did that, and then I just doubled up on the ground. And so now this is connected to what would be a constant power as long as the fuse is on, which is what you want for the camera, to always have power. You wouldn't want to accidentally connect it to an outlet that's powered by a light switch or something like that. So you want to make sure it always has power. And then, well, the last little thing I did is I cut a little notch with my Dremel tool up here in the the outlet box, so that this Romex could kind of fit in there. And then the outlet plate could fashion back on the top of this and look clean. So I'm going to stuff all this back up in there, turn the power back on, and see if the camera fires up. Well, that's a good sign. The lights came on, so that means the power is working. So the next step then is for me just to have a look at my Ring app and make sure that my settings are all correct for motion and for camera positioning. But not too difficult of a project to be able to hang that light. Obviously the biggest challenge is just running the Romex through the outside wall and then wiring it up. But not too bad. It's obviously not the cleanest thing. Ideally, it'd be great if you were able to bury this in your drywall, but I'm not about to tear off the drywall off my ceiling. So this looks good for now, and this will work and help keep my family safe. Ring camera installation complete.